Athletics Kenya has vehemently dismissed claims of bribery to reduce a failed drug test ban by Joyce Zakari and Francisca Koki, who are currently serving a four-year ban. The two accused Mwangi of asking for a 2.5 million shillings bribe from each of them. The bribery claims are under investigation by the IAAF Ethics Commission.
And the athletes were convicted and sanctioned according to the rules. What's interesting is the fact that these athletes have decided, even after having known that they have, according to the rules, they have a leeway to appeal in a normal procedural manner, they have just decided to go out there and make some reckless claims, which for us we are finding very interesting, and that's why we said we'd like to follow these up to the letter and through the legal processes that we have in the country. It's also good to note that these athletes are policemen, or they're in the force. So if anything of that kind happened, why did they not report then? Why did they not use the usual legal proceedings? And the point here is, whether anyone asked them for a bribe or not, did they test positive? That is a big question here. They did, and is it Athletics Kenya or the CEO who gave them the banned substances? Obviously not. So they should be telling the athletes have let Kenyans down, because we selected them to the national team to go to Beijing to carry the national flag. Instead, they went there and let Kenyans down because they were cheats. Now, they cheated once. They cheated people in Beijing, and now again they have come down here. They are doing the same thing. So clean, and they can test me. You know, if I was not clean, then I would be scared. I'm not scared.